Go.
Okay, so we have a pit and a pendulum.
Character and setting. The character of the short story does not give us his name, so he's just considered the narrator. Short story takes place in Toledo, Spain. The time period is during the Spanish Inquisition. The story starts off in a courtroom, and after being sentenced, the narrator is in a dungeon or cell. The room has iron walls, and there is a large pit in the center of the cell.
So the plot, so the exposition or the beginning of it is that the narrator is sentenced to death in a courtroom. He does not tell us the crime that he committed, but after hearing that he's going to be sentenced to death, he passes out. When he wakes up, he finds himself surrounded in darkness. After a few minutes, he tries to get up and figure out like the outline of his room, so he like tries to follow the wall. He ends up slipping and falling, and then he falls asleep. So when he wakes up again, he finds that there's been like a loaf of bread and a pitcher of water by him, so he figures that there's somebody watching him. He gets up to walk across the room and falls again. He then ends up finding like the edge of the pit that's in the middle of the room. He goes back to the edge of the room and then falls asleep again. He wakes up, sees another loaf of bread and a pitcher of water. He drinks the water, and it ends up being drugs, so he obviously falls asleep again, wakes up, and he is strapped to a wooden board on the floor. His head and his left arm are the only thing that are free, so he has a rope tied around him. The light is on, so he can finally see the room that he's in. He sees a pendulum above him. After a while, he sees the pendulum is actually a sharp blade. And it is swinging back and forth and getting closer to him, so it's like descending. After watching the pendulum for a couple of hours, the narrator finally decides that he wants to escape. There's been a plate of meat laying by him this whole time, but the rats, he has rats all over him as well. They actually end up eating it, but I don't know, he takes like grease from the bowl and he puts it on the strap that's across his body, so then the rats are attracted to it, so then they come and gnaw on the
strap.
Yep. And so then this is all happening while this pendulum is getting closer to him, so like by the time this happens the pendulum is like inches away from his body
and those rats, like,
yeah, and so once the thing comes like swinging across, he like rolls over really fast and he gets free, and then right when he does that, the pendulum moves, goes back up, and he finally thinks like, oh, I'm free, you know, like I'm finally okay. But then he sees that the walls of the room are like becoming distorted, so it's not just a cell anymore, it's like moving, and so the walls can move.
It's like getting tight.
And they're being heated, so it's hot in the room, and it's iron walls, so they're gonna obviously could burn him. So he's like having this conversation with himself about whether or not he should jump into this pit or if he should just like deal with the thing, like I don't know.
Should he jump or be pushed?
Yeah,
basically.
So like he just is on the edge of the pit, and like right before he's about to jump, this hand like grabs him, and it ends up being one of the French
General LaSalle.
Yeah, he grabs him right before his death, and turns out that the Spanish Inquisition is over, and
he's free.
So
that was kind of a happy ending.
Okay, so in this story, there's not really like a distinct symbolism or theme, I guess. It's more of just like a person's battle with the fact of like.
He uses all five of his senses in like different ways.
Yeah, and like explaining how he had to deal with like the fact that he could die right then and there or go through constantly all these like different torture mechanisms. Yeah.
So the sense of smell, these are quotes out of the reading. At the same time, my forehead seemed bathed in a clammy vapor, and the peculiar smell of decayed fungus arose to my nostrils. They shrank alarmingly back, many sought the well, but this was only for a moment. I had not counted in pain upon their
voracity.
Observing that I remained without motion, one or two of the boldest leaped upon the framework and smelt at the syringe.
So I was talking about the rats, about how they fell into the well.
Sir Single.
Too much exhausted to reflect upon this circumstance, but ate and drank with avidity. And then there's another one that says, upon arousing, I found by my side, as before, a loaf and a pitcher of water. A burning thirst consumed me, and I emptied the vessel at a draught.
Just pick one of those.
The room had been square. I saw that two of its iron angles were now acute, two consequently obtuse. The fearful difference quickly increased with a low rumbling or moaning sound. In an instant, the apartment had shifted its form into that of a lozenge, and now flatter and flatter grew the lozenge with a rapidity that left me no time for contemplation. Its centric and of course its greatest width came just over the young gulf.
We can just do your quiz tomorrow, so go ahead.
Okay, so he uses his sense of hearing. He says, at the same moment there came a sound resembling a quick opening and as rapid closing of a door overhead, while a faint gleam of light flashed suddenly through the gloom and as suddenly faded away. Those are short.
Go ahead.
They swarmed upon me in ever accumulating heaps. They writhed upon my throat. Their cold lips sought my own. I was half stifled by their thronging pressure. Disgust, for which the world has no name, swelled my bosom and chilled with a heavy clamminess my heart. Yet one moment, and I felt that the struggle would be over. Plainly, I perceived the loosening of the bandage. I knew that in more than one place it must be already set. Just talking about the rats in that sentence, too.
There's so many on him, he feels suffocated. Like literally suffocated. Like, you know when someone is pressing on your chest? That's how many rats are on him. That he literally cannot inflate his lungs to full capacity. And we're not talking about mice.
Okay, and like,
why were the rats on him?
We're talking about rats.
The pit was like four rats, too.
They were coming out of the pit.
So he goes through a, like, a number of like torture mechanisms. So like he woke up and it was completely pitch black. Couldn't see a single thing.
Yeah, and then the next time was a pendulum.
And there's a pit in the middle of the room. And
then the next time they're forcing him to go in the pit.
So while most of the other stories have a very clear like moral,
like the point of it.
This story is about psychological and physical torture.
It was like torturing ever since.
And the toll that takes upon the human body.
Or like when one of those senses is taken away, like how much of a problem that can be. Because like he couldn't see in the beginning, so he didn't know where he was. He could have died because he could have fell into the pit right away. Could have like hit his head. It was like the cell was like slimy and had like moss and like it was wet. You know, like. It's like a dungeon, basically. It's not really, like, scary because they kill people, but it's scary because it was on one person and you have to, like, think about how it would feel if you were in that situation.
There are some, if you're interested in learning about the Spanish Inquisition, there are some historians that believed